Hi Doris, welcome to my channel. This is going to be your reading for the second half of April 2023, where I'll be taking a look at your recent past, your current energies, and the immediate future. Please remember that this reading is general and that it may not resonate with all of you out there. All right, Taurus, let's see what energies we have. All right, Taurus. So we have the Seven of Cups, the Page of Cups, and the Six of Cups. So a lot of emotions right now. You could be feeling emotional at this time, a little confused, or maybe you're exploring your options or considering your choices in a certain situation. Could be matters of the heart, but not necessary. The Seven of Cups is indicative of the fact that you could be feeling a little confused when it comes to how you're feeling. And this is in the past. So there was some confusion in the past as to how you were feeling about a certain situation or a certain person. This could also be a person's energy towards you in the past. In the current energy, you have the Page of Cups. So this is a developing energy. A new energy that's around. If it's not a child that you're dealing with, it's an adult or someone who has a childlike energy, or someone who has just come into your life, or not come into your life recently, but someone who is making an emotional offer, but a small one. Like it could just be like a hi or a hello, or you know, can we have a coffee or something? And if it's not someone else, it's you, you know, if it's someone else, it could also be an admirer of yours, Taurus. And if it is not, this is you exploring something which is fairly new to you. You could also be tapping into your psychic abilities at this time, or just, this could be relatively new for you. And the Page of Cups also indicates a message. So this could be psychic messages, or a message from someone else in your current energy. In the immediate future, you have the Six of Cups. So that's a card of coming together with a person from the past. And if it's not a person from the past, it's a past soulmate. This card can also often represent feeling nostalgic about the past, or they could also be children in your energy, or siblings, or just someone with a younger energy. With the Page of Cups and the Six of Cups, so these are both like, they are known for representing children's energies at a time. So if it's not that, it's a soulmate, and who is reaching out from the past, because the Six of Cups is a really special card. It's a cup. In the Six of Cups, there are plants and leaves growing out of it. So that is usually indicative of the fact that some time has passed, or there has been something in the past already. All right, Taurus, let's clarify the Seven of Cups in your recent past. Why the Seven of Cups for Taurus in the recent past? Well, the Seven of Cups, you get the Three of Swords, the Magician, and the Two of Cups. All right. So, Taurus, I see a little bit, actually not a little bit, I see quite a bit of heartbreak and sorrow in the past. There might have been, obviously, this is connected to love, or some a relation or a connection that means a lot to you. And with the Three of Swords, it indicates that there might have been some heartbreak or some sorrow in the past. Something might have ended, not necessarily ended, but with the Seven of Cups, there was a lot of confusion. And, you know, with the Magician following the Two of Cups, it's like you, Taurus, manifested a connection again. Now, I'm not sure if it's the same connection that you manifested again as the Two of Cups, or if it was another connection, but you manifested a connection in the past. And there was some heartbreak in it. So this leads me to feel that maybe you, because this is all clarifying the Seven of Cups, so maybe Taurus, you manifested a now maybe consciously or subconsciously, I think Magician is conscious, so you consciously manifested a connection in the past, but because you were carrying past heartache, unaddressed sorrow and heartache, there was some confusion with the connection that you manifested. Now, the connection was great because the Two of Cups is, again, a, you know, a soulful and a meaningful connection with equal exchange of emotions and feelings. But along with that came a lot of confusion because you seemed to have some unaddressed heartache or grief from the past, which affected the new connection that you formed. Or if it is the same person, then it affected your attempt to re-establish the connection. All right, Taurus, let's look at the Page of Cups in your current energy. Why the Page of Cups for Taurus in their current energy? Why the Page of Cups for Taurus in the current energy? This wanted to come out. The Page of Swords, all right. So for the Page of Cups, you get the Page of Swords, the Star, and the Ace of Pentacles. So something is, Taurus, this looks like a new energy that is there currently around you. It could be related to this connection that you manifested in the past with the Two of Cups. But with the Page of Swords, it's like you could be making notes about someone or studying someone, or this could be someone studying you and observing you. The Page of Swords also represents someone who is a quick thinker and energetic, but these are all cliched stuff. So, you know, with the Page of Swords, it's like, I think this is connected. This is connected to this new relation connection that you connection that you manifested in the past. Now, currently with the Page of Swords and the Page of Cups, it's like what you're feeling and what you're thinking towards this connection is relatively new, you know. And with the Star, there's a lot of hope and a lot of faith and healing that this connection is bringing in with you. And not just this connection, but within yourself, you could be just reinventing yourself, or the inner child in you could be coming alive, you know, with the Star. And the Ace of Pentacles again is like a new beginning. So you're healing yourself. And as you're doing this, you're hoping for a new beginning, a tangible one that will break, you know, with the Ace of Pentacles. This is a stable cycle that, again, you're hoping for with the Ace of Pentacles, a stable one. This could be with yourself or with the relation or the person that you're engaged with, or just generally you're hopeful about a new stable cycle for yourself with or without a relationship, you know. And whatever healing you're doing right now, and this sense of inspiration and hope and how you feel about it and what you're thinking about it is relatively new, which is why the pages are coming up. Or it could be a child in your energy, just simply reading it, you know. This could just be children in your energy. And you could be starting a new cycle with children. I'm not sure, Taurus. Let's look at the Six of Cups in the immediate future for you. Why the Six of Cups for Taurus in the immediate future? Why the Six of Cups for Taurus in the immediate future? For the Six of Cups, you get the Ace of the Eight of Wands, the Queen of Swords, and the Knight of Wands. All right. Okay, Taurus. Now, in the immediate future, there's someone returning. There's some movement that's coming towards you. All right. It could also be you moving, but usually the Knight of Wands is moving from the right to the left. So I see you as the Queen of Swords and an energy that's moving towards you. And this is going to happen quite rapidly. Whatever this exchange of energy that's going to happen between you and this Knight of Wands that's coming towards you, it's going to be a quick exchange of energy. Now, I don't know what is going to come about of it, but it's someone from the past. All right, and it's an energy that's coming, but it's not necessarily going to stay. It's going to come and go, and it's going to happen very fast. These cards are not showing me much, but with the Queen of Swords, Taurus, it indicates that you might have had history with this person, which is why you're showing up as the Queen of Swords, and you're very cautious when this energy is coming towards you, because the Queen of Swords has learned from pain and past experiences, and she rises above that because she's done her healing and you know, she's able to see clearly, the Queen of Swords. And this is because of past experience and hurt. So I feel that this energy that's coming towards you in the past might have, you know, it could be connected to this Three of Swords that you were carrying right in the recent past that the reading started off with, which began your confusion in the current connection that you're in. But I feel like there's something coming back. It could be the past person, or it could just be a new energy that's coming towards you. It could be a new passionate energy that's moving towards you, but you're just very cold, not cold, but very guarded and cautious as this energy moves towards you. Now, I don't know if it's a new or an old energy, but with the Six of Cups, it's indicative of the fact that it is a past soulmate or someone from the past. All right, Taurus, let's see what the universe has for you. We'll get three cards for what the universe has to say. All right, Taurus, for the universe, you get the Justice card, Seven of Pentacles, and the Queen of Pentacles. All right, Taurus. The scales are balancing for you, all right? With the Justice card, it's like the universe is bringing in energies that is bringing in balance and restoring balance in your life. If there had been any kind of disbalance in the past, balance is being restored now. And it's like your hard work is paying off and is leading you to a life of stability and comfort, you know, with your resources. You're showing up very grounded with or without a person. This could be a person that is in your energy who is bringing in this stability. But even if you are in a relationship or in a connection with someone, you're showing up really dependable and nurturing and down to earth. And this is because you have put in a lot of work with the Seven of Pentacles in the past. And now the universe is paying you back. You know, justice is about Justice is about being on, depends on which side you were on. And if you have been working hard, the universe will bless you with it, will bless you with gifts for working hard. And right now it seems like you're being blessed by the universe for all the hard work that you have put in. And it's either a connection that is bringing in stability, or you're bringing in stability within yourself. You know, showing up as the Queen of Pentacles, irrespective of your gender, male, female, doesn't really matter. All right, Taurus, that is what I have for you. These are called Therapets. It's not really an oracle deck, but these are emotional support cards. So if you are emotional at this time and need support, maybe a card would help. So I'm gonna pick one for those of you who might like to hear a message. For Taurus. All right, Taurus, we have, oh, how cute. Look at this. A day doesn't mean, oh, sorry, a bad day doesn't mean a bad life. Tomorrow will be different. All right, Taurus. So, in case you're having a bad day, you know, it's gonna pass and tomorrow will be different. And it seems like, you know, you're doing well at this time. You're harvesting the good things. And with the Seven of Pentacles at this time, you might be wondering, like, where is it? Like, you could be like kind of waiting, because originally in the Seven of Pentacles, the guy's like staring at a plant and he's like wondering about the harvest. It's coming, Taurus. It's coming. Right, Taurus, that is this is what I have for you for now. I hope this helped in some way. Hope to catch you soon again. Bye, take care. And thank you for your patience.